Hey guys, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. I found a very interesting product. It's a small keypad for Stack Overflow. When I want to get help from Stack Overflow while developing, I think it can be very useful as I'm always looking for answers. The design is so slick. You can also change the keycaps, and also you can change each key to your own desired key. Very nice. Kyle mechanical switches are used, and the aluminum body looks very quality. Have you seen this tweet? Jack said he's a full stack developer. I'm also a full stack developer too. What a genius. It's hard for me to write code without the internet. Why not? Among the projects I did, I made a shortcut application with ESP32 based on LVGR 7. It's available for Windows OS and has worked very well. There are a total of 8 shortcuts. It's including task manager, close, minimize, maximize window, task viewer, desktop, file explorer, and log your PC. If you are interested, please take a look. In order to operate this project properly, you must first have the LVGR 7 environment. Anyway, the new version of the shortcut application that I will introduce in this video was created to make the copy and paste very easy for developers. This application works as a Bluetooth LE keyboard, and the target OS is Windows for now. It was made based on LVGR 8, and I used the Raspberry Pi, which is briefly introduced in the previous video. You don't need to use this product to run this application. ESP32 and a display equipped with a graphic IC supported by TFT ESPi or Raspbian GFX can run this application. A total of 5 shortcut keys have been prepared: a web browser launcher, a stackoverflow.com, select all, copy and paste. To open a web browser with the shortcut key, you need to set the shortcut key on Windows first. I will show you in a moment. The Bluetooth icon in the upper right corner appears in blue when connected and in red when not connected. Let me connect it via Bluetooth. You can see the color has changed. Now let's show you something in action. Currently, the device is connected to the PC via Bluetooth. There is a Windows 10 PC screen in front of me. First, press Open Browser to turn on the Chrome browser. The browser has been executed. Now let me open the Stack Overflow website. You see the main screen of the Stack Overflow. I'm searching for ESP32 here and copy any code. Let's choose one of them. Let me drag this code with my mouse. I hit copy. Open any text editor. Let's paste it in Notepad. Voila! You can confirm that it has been pasted. It works fine with no problems. Press select all to select all. I removed all of them by pressing backspace on the keyboard. Press paste again to paste it. As you can see, it works just fine, and you can create your own macro keys and put them in. From now on, let's take a quick look at what we need to run this application. As usual, you can find the link for this code in this video description below. I used the Raspbian GFX and LVGR 8 settings from the previous videos. Also, since the BLE part of the My Shortcuts project using the BLE keyboard library was used as it is, if you want to know more about how this program works, please refer to my Shortcuts project video. It will be helpful. The screen of this application consists of two parts, the header part and the bottom metrics part. In the header, an LV symbol was used in the label to indicate BLE status, and the Stack Overflow image was placed. Since I'm using the Monterey 34 and Monterey 20 fonts, I changed these two fonts to one in the LV config header. When an event occurs on the button, it can be handled through the event handler. The bottom metrics map makes it easy to configure multiple buttons. This is all for the screen. I have configured the screen of the single page application very simply. Let's see which event is called via BLE this time. If you look at my shortcut CP file, you can see which action is called by ID. To launch the Chrome web browser, Shift-Alt-C is an event. You need to register this shortcut key in Google Chrome on Windows. Let me show you how to assign shortcut keys for programs on Windows 10. Find the program you want first. It doesn't matter which program. I'm going to assign keyboard shortcuts to Google Chrome. Create a link in Google Chrome. Simply drag and drop to the desktop. Then in properties, you can register a shortcut key. Register Shift Alt C, the same as the code. With this, I can launch Google Chrome on my device. The following will automatically input the address of Stack Overflow. Next, select or Ctrl A, copy Ctrl-C, and paste Ctrl-V are registered. Again, in my previous MyShortcuts project, I'm detailing the code using the BLE keyboard library. If you want to know more details, please refer to the project. Finally, modify the partition scheme of the device. Because the header image overview is larger than expected, it cannot be uploaded in the default 1.2 MB app size. After selecting the Huge app, you can build and upload it. Currently, my system is a Mac, but there is no problem with connecting a BLE keyboard. Let's try to connect it. My device, MyShortcuts V2, has been detected. If I connect, it will be connected immediately and you can check it on the console. Let me try to disconnect this time. You can confirm that the connection was lost on the console. All works fine. In this video, I introduced the BLE Shortcut version 2 that can be used easily. The advantage of BLE keyboard is that it can be connected to most OSs. It can be produced for not only Mac, Windows, but also iOS and Android mobile devices. If you need a macro key, it'll be good to make your own. You can try making it easily. Today's project ends here. Thanks for watching. See you in the next project.